friends, myself Rakhi, assistant professor in the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering, ABS Engineering College, Ghaziabad, affiliated to Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam Technical University, Lucknow. Today in the series of optical communication lecture, I am going to deliver before you scattering loss, non-linear and the bend loss. This comes under the category of losses which occurs in the optical fiber. Already in the previous lecture, we have discussed about the scattering loss and the linear condition of the scattering loss and its two types, that is Rayleigh scattering and the Mie scattering. So, in this today's lecture, we are going to have a scattering loss type which is non-linear and one of the another loss mechanism, that is the bend loss. Now, in this particular context, I am going to deliver before you non-linear scattering losses. Under that, it has two type, that is stimulated Brillouin scattering and the stimulated Raman scattering, which is most commonly called as the SBS and the SRS. And at last, we will have a fiber bend loss, which is also called as the bending loss. So, under the condition, that is non-linear scattering loss, this comes under the scattering loss in which whenever obstacle of any type comes in the path of the optical signal, it get distracted. It get distracted and that is called the scattering. But in the linear case, there is a relationship between the input and the output, that is in the linear case, there is a linear relationship between the input and the output one. But when this linearity condition does not exist between the output and the input, then it is called as the non-linear condition, and the scattering loss which follows the non-linear principle of propagation is known as the non-linear scattering loss. So, what are the conditions? It occurs at high optical power levels at the in the case of a linear scattering, but does not describe the power level. Basically, it occurs in the lower power level, that is linear scattering loss. But this scattering loss always occur at the high power level. So, there exists a threshold power in this condition. About that, we are going to have discussion. This non-linear scattering causes the optical power from one mode to be transferred in either the forward or the backward direction to the same or the other mode at the different frequency. Another difference comes with the linear case, that means in the linear case, we have already discussed that in the previous lecture, that there is no change of frequency when the scattering occurs, but in this particular case, there exists a change in the frequency. That means input signal and the scattered signals, scattered ray will have a different frequency. If it has a f, it will be f dash, f double dash, f triple dash, or may it is possible that f dash in between also. But there is a change in the frequency from the input and the output which we get after the scattering. It depends critically on the optical power density within the fiber and hence only becomes significant above a threshold power level. What does it mean? That it depends critically upon the optical power density and becomes significant above a threshold value. That is why it is called in the higher optical power level. Until the optical power reaches a particular level, this non-linear scattering does not going to occur. Every non-linear scattering loss has a threshold value. The threshold value, wo value hota hai, jab tak koi system us value ko touch na kar de, usme wo principle exist nahi karta, us process wo exist nahi karta. In various of our device, it is existing that unless or until it reaches the threshold value, it does not operate. Same thing is applicable here. Until or unless optical power level utna aapka utna high na ho, to जो तब जो जो ये इसके थ्रेशोल्ड पावर लेवल को टच कर सके, उसके पहले ये लॉस आपका एग्जिस्ट नहीं हो सकता. दैट मीन्स वी कैन ईजली रिड्यूस दिस लॉस बाय कीपिंग आवर ऑप्टिकल पावर एट द लो लेवल. अगर हम अपने ऑप्टिकल पावर को लो लेवल पे रखेंगे, वी कैन ईजली रिड्यूस दिस पर्टिकुलर लॉस, दैट इज नॉन स्कैटरिंग, नॉन लीनियर स्कैटरिंग लॉस. दिस स्कैटरिंग मैकेनिज्म इन फैक्ट गिव ऑप्टिकल गेन बट विथ अ फेज शिफ्ट इन फ्रिक्वेंसी, दैट्स वाई देर इज अ चेंज इन फ्रिक्वेंसी, thus contributing to the attenuation for light transmission at a specific wavelength. So just listen out the statement that this laws also contribute to the optical gain but with a phase shift. So question arises, if we are telling that as give optical gain, then why it comes under the category of loss? So reason is that here the question is this, ki why it is comes under the loss if we are saying that it gives the optical gain, because it gives the optical gain but with a phase shift. If for example we have a signal which is transmitting ray hai aapka, जो ट्रांसमिट कर रहा है F1 फ्रीक्वेंसी पे, और उस समय इसकी गेन है G, बट आफ्टर अंडरगोइंग द प्रोसेस ऑफ नॉन लीनियर स्कैटरिंग आफ्टर गोइंग थ्रू द प्रोसेस ऑफ नॉन लीनियर स्कैटरिंग इट विल हैव F2 फ्रीक्वेंसी and gain, for example 2G, gain is increasing but at what frequency? It gain is becoming 2G at the F2 frequency, but we are considering for the F1 frequency. So we can easily say that for F1 frequency gain has been reduced, that's why it is comes under the category of loss. The phase shift is responsible. Frequency shift is basically responsible to be called the nonlinear scattering loss as a loss, comes under the category of loss, not the amplification process. So now the types of nonlinear scattering, there are two types of nonlinear scattering. First one is the stimulated Brillouin scattering, which is called as the SBS, stimulated Raman scattering, which is called as the SRS. So SBS and SRS are not usually observed in multimode fibers. They are not usually observed in the multimode fiber because they are relatively large core diameter. Core diameter, multimode fiber already humne jab fiber ke kar rahe the ki jab aapka core diameter hota hai, in the case of a multimode, मल्टीमोड के केस में कोर डायमीटर ज़्यादा होता है, और आपका जब हम इसकी बात करते हैं तो उसके केस में क्लैडिंग की डायमीटर ज़्यादा होती है, कोर का कम होता है इन द केस ऑफ सिंगल मोड. तो रीज़न यहाँ पे क्या है कि आपका जो नॉन लीनियर स्कैटरिंग होता है that requires a threshold level, और जब तक वो threshold level हमारा reach नहीं हो जाता तब तक हमारा attenuation start नहीं होता. So in the case of a multimode fiber, आपका जो core diameter high होता है, large होता है, बड़ा होता है, that makes the optical power, threshold optical power level extremely high, और उसको reach कर पाना मुश्किल हो जाता है, या मतलब बहुत टाइम लगता है, या फिर हम नॉर्मली अवॉइड करते हैं. दैट्स व्हाई दिस आर नॉट अब्सॉर्ब्ड इन द मल्टीमोड फाइबर, बिकॉज इन द मल्टीमोड फाइबर ड्यू टू लार्ज कोर डायमीटर द ऑप्टिकल थ्रेशोल्ड पावर आर एक्सट्रीमली हाई. नाउ द स्टिम्युलेटेड ब्रिलियन स्कैटरिंग. सो व्हाट इज द एसबीएस? may be regarded as the modulation of light through thermal molecular vibration within the fiber. So, SBS is regarded as the modulation, that means change in the whenever there is a change in the something with respect to either amplitude or other frequency, jab hum change kuch karte hain, that comes under the category of or phase modulation. So, in this particular case, that is SBS, modulation of light occurs due to thermal molecular vibration within the fiber. The scattered light appear as upper and lower side bands. So, whatever with the scattered light will appear as the upper and the lower side band of the original light wave signal, because in this particular thing there is a frequency change, frequency shift also occurs. Frequency shift occurs, that is why if the original frequency is f, the shifted frequency may be f minus f 1 or f plus f 1. So, this is the scattered one and it will appear as the lower side band or the upper side band. In all the modulation process, when we talk about in general amplitude modulation process, then in that case there exists a, after modulation there exists a lower side band, upper side band and the main signal. Same thing here, because there is a change in the frequency, frequency shift hoti hai kuch na kuch values se. So, it appears as the lower or the upper side band due to frequency shift. The frequency shift is basically main reason for that. The incident photon in this scattering process produces a phonon of acoustic frequency as well as the scattered frequency. So, in this particular case, incident photon after scattering produces a phonon of acoustic frequency and as well the scattered photon, both are existing here. This produces an optical frequency shift which varies with the scattering angle. A frequency shift hoti hai in all the non-linear scattering process with the scattering angle. The frequency shift is maximum in the backward direction. We have to remember this line, that frequency shift is maximum in the backward direction, reducing to 0 in the forward direction, making SBS a mainly backward process. So, as we have seen in non-linear process, linear process also, that is my scattering basically occurs in the forward direction and in the backward direction it is minimum. In non-linear also, when we talk about the SBS, it occurs mainly in the backward direction and in the forward direction it is minimum. So, SBS is basically mainly a backward process. Say in linear case, my scattering is basically a forward process. So, this is a small terms which has we have to remember, because this may be asked for in the MCQ part of any optical communication paper. Now, whenever we talk about that key on in nonlinear scattering, each and every signal has to achieve a threshold value, threshold power level before attenuation, this type any attenuation in non-linear scattering will occur. So, in Brillouin scattering, that threshold level is given by this one. Again, I am writing it for you, which is given by PB, 4.4 into 10 to the power of minus 3 d square, that is diameter of the core. So, that is why it is saying, if multimode fiber, if the diameter is increased, this threshold power will also increase. The threshold power bahut zyada ho jayega multi mode fiber mein. Single mode fiber mein ye significant hota hai, kyunki single mode fiber mein diameter kam hota hai. Agar hum aur multi mode ki jab hum baat karte, in multi mode fiber diameter goes on increasing. Diameter jitni zyada ho jayegi, ye threshold power of course increase hota hai parallelly uske, aur itna zyada ho jayega that we will not able to attain that level of threshold, so that attenuation can happen. Lambda square, that is, it is also dependent upon the frequency or wavelength which we are selecting for propagation. Alpha dB, that is attenuation parameter, nu is the, now d and lambda are the fiber core diameter and the operating wavelength, aur dono ki unit hoti hai micrometers mein, alpha dB is the fiber attenuation decibel per kilometer, nu is the source bandwidth in gigahertz. So don't get confused with the lambda and the nu. Lambda is the operating wavelength and the nu is the source bandwidth, source ki aapki bandwidth jisse aapka signal emit ho raha hai. Source aap optical source ke bare mein thoda sa introduction aapko diya hi hua hai, introduction part of the optical communication. So nu is the source bandwidth which occurs in the gigahertz range, which is the optical range. Now the second type of the non-linear scattering, which is the stimulated Raman scattering, which is in also known as SRS. It is similar to SBS in all respect. The difference is that the high frequency optical phonon rather than acoustic phonon is generated in the scattering process. When you talk about the SBS mein aapka acoustic phonon release hota hai and SRS mein aapka optical phonon release hota hai. Difference between the SRS and SBS is also asked sometimes in any examination. So, you have to differentiate. Second one, ye jo optical phonon hota hai, iski frequency high hoti hai than the acoustic phonon. Third, aapka jo difference nikal ke aayega, that is from the next statement. It has an optical power threshold up to 3 orders of magnitude higher than the Brillian one. Threshold power जो SBS का है, for example it is A, तो उसका 3 times ज़्यादा होगा in the case of SRS. SRS में threshold power 3 times 3 fold ज़्यादा हो जाता है approximately. So इसको SRS किसी भी system में होना और भी difficult process है. जब optical power level आपका और बड़ा हो रहा है, that means you have to attain that level so that SRS can happen. So इसका होना और भी डिफिकल्ट चीज है. पहले तो हमने ये कह दिया कि नॉन लीनियर स्कैटरिंग का होना ही डिफिकल्ट है, क्योंकि इट हैज टू अटेन अ पर्टिकुलर थ्रेशोल्ड लेवल बिफोर इट स्टार्ट गोइंग टू बी हैपन. दूसरा हम कह रहे हैं कि एसआरएस जो उसके दो पार्ट है, एसबीए और एसआरएस, उसमें भी एसआरएस का होना और डिफिकल्ट है बिकॉज इसमें 3 फोल्ड ज्यादा हो जाता है आपका ऑप्टिकल पावर लेवल, थ्रेशोल्ड पावर लेवल. तीसरा पॉइंट जो हम यहां कह रहे हैं कि मल्टी मोड में नहीं होता है, इन सिंगल मोड होता है. क्यों होता है? क्योंकि इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द डी स्क्वायर डायमीटर ऑफ द कोर, और आपका मल्टी मोड में डायमीटर ज्यादा होता है एज कंपेयर टू सिंगल मोड, बहुत ज्यादा होता है डायमीटर एज कंपेयर टू सिंगल मोड. तो डायमीटर ज्यादा जैसे ही होगा, ऑफ कोर्स आपके थ्रेशोल्ड पावर लेवल की वैल्यू भी उसके करस्पॉन्डिंग ज्यादा हो जाएगी, और उसको अटेन करेंगे तभी हमारा. तो लोअर पावर लेवल में ये लॉस होना बहुत मुश्किल है. इट इज ऑलवेज अकर्स इन द higher power level. Now, the threshold power level of the SRS, that is given by PR is equal to 5.9 into 10 to the power of minus 2 D square, that is the diameter of the core, lambda, that is the operating wavelength, alpha dB is our attenuation. Of course, the unit is watt here. Now, if we are saying that for any operating wavelength or any fiber, SRS threshold power, that is PR, is greater than the threshold power of SBS. Just have a proof of this. For the proving this, just have a numerical based on this. This is just a formula based numerical, and we will have a compare the threshold power level in the SBS and the SRS. So, just have a readout of the question. A long single mode optical fiber has an attenuation of 0. dB per kilometer, that is alpha dB, which is required for calculating the threshold power, is given as 0.5 dB per kilometer. When operating at a wavelength of 1.3, that is lambda, is given as 1.3 into 10 to the power of minus 6. The fiber diameter is 6 micrometer, that is D is given as 6 micrometer and the laser source bandwidth that is nu is equal to 600 megahertz. Compare the threshold power level. So, by using the formula for SBS and the SRS, what we are getting? When we have put the PB, when they put the P value in this equation, which is of PB 4.4 to the power minus 3 d square lambda square alpha dB nu, we get putting the value on this equation 4.4 into the power minus 3 d square diameter value already given in the question, lambda square already shown here, what is the value of lambda, alpha dB 0.5 nu 600 meter 600 megahertz. By putting all that value, we get the PB as 80.3 milliwatt. Similarly, for calculating the threshold power level of Raman stimulated Raman scattering, that is SRS, here is the formula 5.9 to 10 to the power minus 2 into d square lambda alpha dB. This is this d is 6 micrometer, lambda 1.3 into the power minus 6, alpha dB 0.5 dB. By putting the value, we get this in watt, 1.38 watt. This is in watt and this is milliwatt. So, of course, this one is the higher one, optical power. So, PR is greater than PB. Proved. All the parameters are same, but PR is greater than PB. Now comes the bend loss. So, whenever already we have told discussed in the previous lectures also, whenever there is some change either in the form of fluctuation or in the form of downward fluctuation or in the form of any form, or we bend the fiber completely, or there is a fiber and it has a some fluctuation in between, all will leads to change in the path of ray propagation. Jesse, it will lead to the change in path, it will leads to the change in mode, it will lead to change in the mode and it will leads to attenuation or loss in the optical fiber propagation. The optical fiber suffers radiation loss at bends or curves, bend or curves. It is due to the energy in the evanescent field at the bend exceeding the velocity of the light in the cladding, and hence the guidance mechanism is inhibited, which causes light energy to be radiated from the fiber. So, what is bend? Whenever bend is going to happen, and we know that velocity, if we talk about the velocity, velocity is dependent upon the refractive index. And the refractive index of the core and the cladding is different. So, as the refractive index of the core and cladding is different, velocity is also different. So, there will be a bend jab bhi aapka hoga, in that case agar aapka light ray propagate karega and it will move towards the cladding and it will move leads to the radiation, and radiation comes under the loss part. Or the part of the light mode which is outside of the bend has to be travel faster than at the inside, so that jo outside mein it has to travel faster so that it can reach the destination at the same time, but this does not happen and this will leads to the loss of radiation of signal in the form of radiation. Now, in continuation with that, we have a radiation attenuation coefficient which is given by alpha t is equal to c 1 exponential c 2 r, where r is the radius of the curvature of the fiber. Radius of the curvature means if we have a bend, what is the that one. C 1 and c 2 are the constant which is independent of r. Large bending loss tend to occur in a multimode fiber. Now, there is also a loss of two type. First one is the large land macro or micro. So, this one is the macro one, which exists in the multimode fiber, at critical radius of curvature, that is given by this value. RC should be equal to 3 n 1 square lambda 4 pi n 1 square minus n 2 square, already known to you. N 1 is the refractive index of the core and n 2 is the refractive index of the cladding. So, as per the equation suggests that this macro bending loss, which is occurs in the case of a multimode fiber, can be reduced by designing of the fiber with large refractive index difference. So, this is the formula for refractive index. Basically, large refractive index relative is given by this one, and this we can easily say that up till this value exists in this equation, lambda has to be removed. So, if we take denominator is in the del part. So, if we if this value is increased, then of course, R C can be reduced and a shorter wavelength, lambda wavelength here. So, this is the Proyadoop method by which we can reduce the macro bending loss. And similarly, for a single mode fiber in which we have a micro bending loss, the radius of curvature for that is given by this 20 lambda n 1 minus n 2 half 2.748 minus 0.996 lambda by lambda c, where lambda c is your cutoff wavelength to the power minus 3. Let us do our numerical related to that, in which we have a two step index fiber. First one is the multimode fiber and the second one is the single mode fiber. First one, multimode, we have a refractive index of core refractive index of 1.5 and relative refractive index of 3% and operating wavelength of this one, that is n 1 is relative refractive index, that is del is this one, del co n 1 square minus n 2 square upon 2 n 1, we have to remember this is of 3% and operating wavelength of 0.82 micrometer. So, first of all we will have this. So, del here, first of all we have to, for the formula of a multimode, we have to know the value of 3 n 1 lambda n 1 square minus n 2 square. We have a value of n 1 square in the numerical, we have a value of lambda, but we do not have a value of n 2. So, for calculating the radius of curvature, first of all we have to calculate the value of n 2. So, here the formula for relative refractive index is taken. This difference is taken, and after that we will get the value of n 2 square is equal to 2.115, and putting that in the formula already we have for multimode, we get the RC as 9 micrometer, which is our answer. Now, for the second one, second part of this question, 8 micrometer diameter is given, D, single mode fiber having a core refractive index same as A, that is n 1 is given as 1.5, relative refractive index of 0.3, that is different from the first one, and operating wavelength of 1.55 micrometer, that is also different from the first one. So, we will use this formula, that is the critical radius of curvature for the single mode fiber. We have used this formula, but again same as the part A, first of all we have to calculate the n 2 using the relative refractive index difference formula. We have calculated the n 2 here, but one thing, in this formula we are also required to calculate the lambda c for the single mode fiber. So, we have used the formula for the single cutoff wavelength for the single mode fiber, and as per putting the formula we already have A value, D value is given with us. So, A can be calculated by D by 2, n 1 is given, del is given. So, after putting the value we get the value as lambda c is equal to 1.214 micrometer. And now we have with the all the values which is required for calculating the radius of curvature of a single mode fiber by putting all the dead value in the formula, that is this one, this formula, this is the formula for radius of curvature for single mode fiber. When we put all the values, we get the as 34 micrometer. So this is 9 micrometer and this is the 34 micrometer. So this comes under the micro bending and this the macro bending. So here comes the end of our scattering and the bending loss. In the coming lecture, we will discuss other forms of attenuation or the losses which occurs in the optical fiber. Thank you.